Good morning. So today we are going to discuss about the working on heights or working at heights. So this part is covered under this the construction safety as well as the quality control subject under this advanced diploma in industrial safety. Now why this topic is needed, why topic is important? For that purpose we must know about the reasons or the causes of accidents and some legal requirement. So the moral responsibility as far as the safety is concerned is to ensure our colleagues return home without being hurt at work. Now what is the legal requirement? So changing our legal duties as per the various applicable statutes, that is mainly Factory Act 1948, and for the Maharashtra it is Maharashtra Factory Rule 1963. Now there are different causes of accident and some cost of accidents like loss of manpower, retraining cost, damaged materials, lower morale, loss of profit, etc. So we have already discussed what exactly the accidents, what are the causes of accident as per this IS 3786, etc. Now we are not going to go in detail about these things, but we are discussing about the background of why this working at height is required, why it is important. Then in human resources, work and job structuring, moral and retaining people, positive health structure. So these are the requirements or the parameters under this importance of safety. So what are the causes of this accidents? So this accident may be due to absent-mindedness, may be due to carelessness, casual approach, indiscipline, dangerous acts, experiment, no knowledge and tiredness. So this ACCIDENT. So these are the different causes of accidents. The main three causes of accidents are didn't listen, didn't look and didn't ask. So if you are not knowing about anything else, then you can ask. If you don't observe anything, then the chances of accidents are more. And if after accident, if you are learning many things or you are discussing many things, then there is no point in discussion. It is useful only for the future perspective. But if it is happen, then there is no use of discussing these things. So prevention is better than cure. That is the main thing in the accidents. Now the chapter or the topic is working at height. So from this picture also you can understand why this working at height is important. So these are some points which are under construction. So there are chances of falling objects mainly from the construction sites, and that are the chances for in the other sites also. But this is the main risk of falling the tools and hitting the people. So from this picture also you can understand why the working at height is important. Falls are the number one cause of fatalities. So under the fatalities or the statistical data says that the fall of person, fall of objects and hitting of objects, these are the different reasons for the fatalities in the construction industry according for approximately 56% of all the fatalities. So that is why these working at height precautions are very essential. All employees shall be protected from falls of 2 meter or more by the use of an approved fall protection systems. So we must understand what exactly this fall protection system is, which fall protection systems are available, and training for this fall protection system is also necessary. So the basic height for fall protection system is nothing but the 2 meter. So we will discuss about why this 2 meter, why this 3 meter, etc. Then railings are required at permanent elevated locations greater than or equal to 1.3 meter. So if these things are required, if the space is more, then the railings are essential. Now this picture also indicates that if working at height is not essential, or you can, if you avoid this working at height more than 2 meter or 3 meter, then that is the basic or engineering solution for prevention or for avoiding this working at height hazards. So there may be some risk assessment for these falling objects. If the working at height work is not available, then you must wear some personal protective equipments, and you must ask the person to go through the trainings of all these fall protection devices. Then and then only that person is allowed to go for that work, that is nothing but working at height. So some work permit systems are also there. So this work permit system is allowed to that person for the working at height. Work at height always carry serious hazards of fall causing and injury, including fatal injury. So fall is the main hazard. So that may be a tool, that may be some instruments, or that may be a person. The risk of injury is related to the distance of the fall. No great surprises. So what is your chance of dying in fall? So we can understand from the graph or the statistical data, whatever we have. So this death graph clearly indicates what is the probability of the death or the fatality with respect to the height as well as with the impact speed. Now on the x-axis, it gives us the impact speed, that is kilometer per hour, and on y-axis, percentage of probability of death. So if the height is near about 5 meter, so the probability of death are more, and if the height is 16.5 meter then there is a 100% chances of death. So this indicates that we must avoid these heights, especially not more than 5 meter. So there are chances or the probability is increasing from this 5 meters up to 16.5 meters. Then this death graph clearly indicates this 5 meter and the 25% chances, and 16.5 meter 100% chances. So please note that the potential for the serious disabling injuries remains from fall from any height. Now safety at height. So the main hazard is fall. So fall may be defined as first and last lesson, right? So working at height is determined as 1.8 meter or more and applies to an area where it is possible for a person to fall 1.8 meters or more from one level to another. So this is the basic determination or working at height, where we can apply these working at height principles or the guidelines to follow for that working at height. So minimum 1.8 meter, that is nothing but approximately 2 meter. That is why there are many guidelines which are given at the baseline, that is 2 meter. Why only 1.8 meter? The first lift on the scaffold platform is 1.8 meter. Preventing fall of material and person while working. So we can use these equipments like ladders, scaffold, safety equipment and devices to prevent the fall of material or a person while working. So there are some work or essential work which can be done on height only, right? So if the work is not avoidable, then we have to use these instruments like ladder, scaffolds or some equipments. So there are different types of ladders, that may be single ladder, shape ladder, extension ladder, and this classification or type may be different in different books. Nowadays also, with the help of some new equipments or instrument, these types of classification differs. Now what exactly is single ladder? So there's single section only. So there is only one section, that is why it is called as single ladder. Length not more than 4.5 meter. Right, so the length of this single ladder is 4.5 meter. Distance between the lungs 250 to 350 mm. Must support the 4 times the maximum load. So whatever the load is there, so that single ladder supports 4 times the maximum load. Should be tied at 2 points. That is nothing but the locking of that particular single ladder, and the slope ratio is 1:4. must extend 1 meter above platform. So these are the some salient features of this single ladder. Now, what is a shape ladder? Overall height not more than 6 meter. Now, here the maximum height is 6 meter. Don't use top platform, because if you want to use the top platform, then you should prefer the scaffolding rather than the ladders. Distance between the lungs is near about same as single ladder, that is 250-350 mm, 250-350 mm. The support or maximum load capacity is same, that is 4 times the maximum load, and minimum width 30 cm at top with spread of 25 mm for every 30 cm length. So these are the some again salient features of shape ladder. So there are different ladders and it is not banned from the use. So some basics of these ladders are, you can understand from the picture also that what exactly the angle should be, what is the exact position, what are the lockings for these ladders. So before using the ladder, you must check the condition, you must check the maintenance record whether it is okay or not. Then short duration task, that is 30 minutes, not more than that. 3 points of contact in use, so 3 point contact is there. Then check for obstruction, doors, windows, check for overload power lines and ground level, use level devices. You must check the overhead lines, that is at height from that ladder. Then you must also check whether the surface is clear or not. You must check the contact points and the angle of that particular ladder before using. So these are the pictures which can indicate do's and don'ts. So this is the proper position, so that is the gesture and posture, and how to handle this type of material. So here it is not recommended because your hand is involved to carry this material. So point of contact is only 1 and 2, but it is required 3 point of contact. So this hand and the legs, right? Now this is another picture which shows the exact location, the exact gesture and posture, and the locking position. So this is the lock, this is the ground level lock, this is the top level lock, and this angle of a person who is working on height is not recommended because the point of contact is again missing and less surface is attached to that ladder. The weights, that is 10 kg is recommended, 25 kg maximum to be lifted. Use tools well, then medically fit, footwear suitable and in good condition. Hold rungs when ascending or descending. Use standoff devices if needed. Don't use normal ladders on roof, use proper roof ladder. So there are different types of ladder, which is for the normal use, which is for the roof, which may be used for another things or maybe for the overhead lines maintenance, that is electrical maintenance, etc. So there are different ladders and that appropriate ladder should be selected for that particular work. Don't use domestic grade at work. Ladders, one person use only. Don't span planks across between the rungs. Consider mobile steps with handrails as alternative. So from this picture also you can clear this. Two clear rungs, don't work any higher up by this tray pipe. So this top portion should not be used. You must avoid this top portion because this is not designed for that particular load carrying capacity. Now this picture again indicates the do's and don'ts for the ladder use. So this angle is of ladder, and if you want to use, then that should be your total body should be parallel to that ladder only. Then only it is a safe. Now in this picture, it is clearly indicate that this ladder and the body of that person is parallel and it is safe to work. The lethal ladders, make sure that ladder is right for the job. Wood scaffolding or a cherry picker be better. So you have to first think about whether the ladder is suitable or scaffolding is suitable, and after that ladder, which type of ladder is suitable, whether it is in good shape, secured near the top on a firm base and footing. So that 1:4 ratio, 4 up 1 out, rising at least 1 meter beyond the landing place, or that there is a proper handhold. So all these things should be checked before using the ladder. Always have a firm grip on the ladder and keep a good balance. Keep your hands free and tools in a shoulder bag or belt attachment. So from this picture also you can understand what are the do's and don'ts. Work should only be carried out from a ladder when the job is of short duration, that already discussed, that should be less than 30 minutes and can be carried out safely. For added safety, the base of the ladder should be asked or buried to prevent slipping. So some locking provision should be there at ground as well as at the top level. Ensure your footwear is free from excessive mud or grease before you climb up the ladder. So to avoid the slip trip, your footwear should be clean before going to use that ladder. Always face the ladder. That is parallel to the ladder. Your body is parallel to the ladder only. Then there are hazards. Don't stand ladder on drum, box or other unstable base. So this bottom portion of this ladder should be locked at the ground level. Never attempt to repair broken ladders. So we have to replace that ladder only. Never carry loads up ladders, hoist it up. Ladder rungs must not be used as improved ramps. When using metal or metal reinforced ladders, make sure that there are no electrical hazards in the near vicinity. So that electrical hazard may be on the side, but you should focus mainly on the overhead lines. No matter how quickly a job can be done, there is always time to fall. So again, you can understand from this picture that what is unsafe and safe acts on the ladder. Now these are the summary of these do's and don'ts related to the ladders. Angle should be approximately 75 degree to horizontal, ratio 1:4, 4 up and 1 down. Then styles to extend at least 1 meter above the step off point. No rung should be missing. Placed at the level of platform. Firm and fitted with a non-slippery foothead. Rung shall be clear of oil, grease, and secure the top of the ladder as needed. So these are the things that is nothing but the do's for the ladders. And what are the don'ts? Hang any tool from the rungs. Stand any higher than the third rung from the top of the ladder. Keep metal and wet wooden ladders near live electrical circuits. So this may be acts as a electrical conductor. So we must avoid these things. Use ladder horizontally as a work platform. Stretch or reach beyond the side rails of a ladder. You could lose your balance. So we have already discussed that. Our total body and the gesture and posture should be in a such a way that total body is parallel to the ladder. That should not be away from that ladder, because again that balance may change. Now the second and most important is scaffolding. So to prevent from the hazard that is working at height, we can use the scaffolding. So there are different types of scaffolding, and again that scaffolding types and classification may change time to time. So the basic types are supported scaffolding, suspended scaffolding, and aerial lifts. So that is boom trucks and crane. Now what are the hazard or risk involved in that working at height and scaffolding? So failure to secure the scaffold to the building, then inadequate bracings, failure to brace it adequately, inadequately supported scaffold boards erected on uneven ground. So if the platform or that surface is uneven, then there is a risk. If the boards are not clearly supported, then there is a risk. Use of unsuitable or faulty materials, so you have to check before using this scaffolding. Absence of suitable numbers of couplers, inadequate access or unsecured ladders, inadequate or irregular platforms width, overloading of platform and scaffold, absence of toe guards and guardrails. So there are different types and different hazards involved in that scaffolding. So overloading, then material checking, then maintenance checking, whether the guards or the absence of toe guards and guardrails should be checked before using this scaffolding. Then some precautions to be taken, that may be for regarding the surface, that is that surface should be firm, whether it is at same level and compacted, then sole plate below the base plate, staging braces at every height of 6 meters, and sufficient diagonal bracing. So all these things are should be checked as a precautionary measures for the scaffolding. Then scaffolding erection and dismantling contains that skilled workmen with the supervision of competent supervisor, vacating of area, then lifting of frame and other parts. Ladder should be used for climbing up and down. Lower all the loose scaffold materials down, and double lanyard safety harness should be used. So that ladder should be used for reaching up to the platform. You should check the ladder, you should check the platform, you should check the all the materials and the elements which are involved in the scaffolding before climbing up on the scaffolding platform. Using ladders or scaffolding without proper fixing is crazy. Putting up scaffolding, removing tines, taking it down again is a job for trained and experienced scaffolders. So that trained people only are allowed for scaffolding work. Never use incomplete scaffolding, always inspect it before use. Putting up scaffolding, removing ties and taking it down again is a job that is for trained and experienced persons only. Make sure that there is a safe access, handrails and toe boards at all edges. So you have to check the handrails as well as the safe access and toe boards. Things fall on sides, wear your helmet. So you have to wear helmet, you have to wear some safety harnesses, you have to wear safety shoes. We have to wear hand gloves if needed and some other personal protective equipments before doing the work on the scaffolding. So mobile scaffold towers are also available for the construction work or the work where the expansion is going on. So before erection, check all components are in good condition. Check wheels for effective rotation, because now it is a mobile scaffold, so wheels are attached at the bottom of the scaffold, check brakes and locking devices work correctly, prior to erecting towers on suspended floors, ensure bearing capacity of floor is sufficient for the plan load. So you have to check the bearing capacity, that is safe working load, for working on the scaffold. Before use, ensure the tower is vertical and square. Tower must not be used unless the wheels are locked. So after mobiling or after moving that particular scaffold tower at a particular location where you have to work, after that particular point or location, you should lock the wheels to avoid the movement. Then check that outriggers are set correctly and secured. Ensure the platform is fully boarded out and guardrails and tow boards are fitted if working platform is over 2 meters, right? So you have to check that height, that is nothing but the baseline as a 2 meters. So this is nothing but the mobile scaffolding again. When freestanding height not exceed 4 times the minimum base, that is the base dimensions, to support the 4 times the maximum intended load, all wheels shall be provided with a positive locking device to be braced by cross bracing or diagonal braces or both. Platform shall be tightly decked, secured against displacement. Platform shall be provided with guardrails. Now, when you are working on the roof, that is the again risky operation. So before working on roofs, fragile materials should be identified and precautions decided. So that fragile material which can be damaged easily due to your load, and this material can be deteriorated easily due to continuous sunlight or due to the rains on the in a rainy season. So after the combination of this rain striking and sunlight, that material may get deteriorated, and that roofs are called as fragile roofs. So you have to check whether the fragile materials are available on the roofs or not. Roof edge barriers, that is our scaffolds, must be erected to prevent people and material falling. So you have to check whether the roof edge barriers are available or whether you have to use that scaffolding to avoid the material falling or the people falling. Access ladders must be a safe distance above the stepping off point, must be secured. Where access ladders rise above 9 meters, a safe intermediate platform must be provided. So you can understand from this picture how risky is to operate on the fragile roof or any type of roof which is having more than 2 meter height. So hazard of working on roofs: if you can fall more than 2 meters, guardrails and tow boards must be erected. Hazard resulting from adverse weather condition must be anticipated and suitable precautions should be taken. So before starting the actual operation on a particular roof, you have to identify the conditions about the weather forecast. Wet, windy or icy weather can seriously affect safety. Then this is the schematic diagram for the tower scaffolds, which can be used for more than 2 meter or 3 meter height. The key safety facts for this tower scaffolds are: assembled and used by trained people, stable, tied to structure if possible, assembly complete. Before use, fully boarded and no gap should be there. Don't ride on when moving or remove the equipments. So hand guardrails, that is this diagram again showing that there should be some 950 mm, 420 mm and 150 mm. So this is the combination of this all types of handrails. So depending on the type of scaffolding or the tower scaffold, depending on the dimensions of these scaffolds, the handrails dimensions are decided. Now for these purposes, to work at height or before using these ladders or scaffold, any type of, you have to take a permit. So if you are going to work more than a 2 meter or 3 meter height, then you should go through the work permit systems. So permit to halt work, then working in confined spaces, working in the excavation works, in the flammable lines, in the electrical installations. These are the different systems where the work permit is required. And now one of the parameter is working on height or fragile roof. So this is the element where work permit system is needed. So you should go through this work permit systems. What is work permit? It is a formal written statement used to control certain types of work that are potentially hazardous. It allows to start the work only after safe procedures have been defined and they provided a clear record that all foreseeable hazards have been considered. So before starting any hazardous work, you have to go through this system that is called as work permit systems. So there are different checklist or checkpoints are there. So before giving the permission to work, you have to go through this checklist or checkpoints. The objective of this work permit system is to identify the hazards, communicate that hazard, then accident prevention, safety precautions, ensuring the precautions provided, setting roles and responsibilities, communication with the concerned departments or the persons involved in the work. So if you want to repair something, if you want to maintain something, if you want to do some maintenance work or some new work, then you should go through these work permit systems. So for that purpose, expertise is going to identify the hazard. Then after identifying hazard, what type of hazard is there, what is the level of that hazard, all these things are communicated to that people who are actually going to that work. Then what are the chances of accident and what are the prevention methods, what are the safety precautions should be followed, that is again communicated to that persons, and all these responsibilities and roles are setting up by that expertise or that manager of that particular section. What is the legal requirement of this work permit system? So as per Factory Act 1948 and MFR, that is Maharashtra Factory Rule 1963, it is made mandatory to follow the safe procedures or the work permit system for various hazard potential work. The requirements are mentioned in the following rules, that is 72, 73, 73C, 73F of Maharashtra Factory Rule 1963. So these are the legal requirements under the Factory Act as well as under the MFR 1963. Now this rule 73F clearly mentioned that there are different provisions under the rules for this height work permit. So fragile roof is the main focus. Fragile roofs, provisions of crawling boards, etc., etc. In any factory, no person shall be required to stand or pass over or work on or near any roof or ceiling covered with fragile materials like AC sheets or similar material through which he is liable to fall in case it breaks or given away a distance of more than 3 meters, unless suitable and sufficient ladders, duck ladders or crawling boards which shall be securely supported are provided and used, and a permit to work on the fragile roof is issued to him each time he is required to work thereon by a responsible person of the factory concerned. So this is the basic requirement and a specific reference of the legal requirement, that is rule number 73F, where it is clearly mentioned that if you are working on more than 3 meters height, then you should use the crawling board or the other provisions which is required to prevent that accidents. Right? So there may be a ladders, there may be a crawling board or some other instruments which can prevent the accident. So fragile material means sheet made of asbestos. So this is the conventional methods to prepare that particular sheets, that is called as asbestos as a material. this asbestos cement are made from the similar materials such as perspex, polyester or other types of plastic fibers. Now these pictures are clearly indicate that what type of scaffolding can be used, how you use this lifeline, safety harnesses and crawling boards. So working on height or fragile roof AC sheets, where work has to be carried out on height more than 3 meters, or fragile roofs like AC sheets. So this is the basic condition and the legal reference from the Maharashtra factory rule. Now what exactly this work permit system contains? So this work permit is nothing but a written statement in which it is clearly mentioned who is going to prepare this work permit, what type of work should be permitted, who is going to review this work permit and who is going to approve this work permit. So all these things are given in the written statement, the specific department, the specific document number, the specific effective date and other details are also given. Now what exactly the objective of that particular work, what is the scope of that particular work permit, then who is responsible for this work permit, who is going to approve this work permit, who is going to prepare or review this permit, and who is going to work on the basis of this work permit. So all these things are written in this written statement. Then permission for that particular time, for that particular date is also mentioned. Then some the detailing of that person who is involved in that particular work permit is also mentioned in this work permit. Then the nature of work is mentioned in the work permit and some checkpoints. So these checkpoints are very important as far as this work permit system is concerned, because normally we are knowing about all these things, but this checkpoint for the work permit is there proper access available to the area to be worked upon? So safe access is the checkpoint. Is there proper barricading done and supervision provided for the guiding and monitoring of the work from the below? So that is again, the barricading is the checkpoint. Are all warning signs in place? So warning signs is another checkpoint. Is the place safe to work alone? Then if any attendant is required, that is again the checkpoint. Are there overhead power cables and other services in the vicinity? So you have to check the overhead lines. Are requisite PPE such as full body harness, safety helmet, shoes are being provided? So these are the checkpoints. So PPE is also one of the checkpoints. What are the key features revised for this work permit? All relative workmen are qualified for height working. All approaches to height work are with low to facility. That is nothing but the lockout and tag out. So we have to provide some tags where all these things are mentioned. Why this energy or why this line is locked or that particular equipment is locked. That is called as lockout and tagout system. That is nothing but load. Vertigo test for those working beyond 3 meters. So vertigo test means whether that person is capable for working at that particular height, that is beyond 3 meters. Work permit signed by department in charge. Daily assurance by safety officer and senior management prior to the start of work, and daily review in the production meetings. So all these features are revised in the works safety works permit systems. So this is the example of working on height, working on fragile roofs. So all the details, all the trainings should be provided to that particular persons. All the tests should be done, and which type of instruments or the equipment that person should use. All this detailing is given in that work permit system itself. So this clearly indicates that helmet is essential in some of the work systems, the safety harnesses, crawling boards, lifeline are the main PPs which is used for the working at height. Then key points to be ensured that proper access available to the location of work, persons are experienced and trained for working of height before start, working on height and fragile is authorized, warning signs are available and displayed at height workplace, proper barricading of area to be done, PP is available and in good condition for use, provisions of scaffolding, mobile ladders, lifelines, platforms and rooftop ladders to be ensured before start of work. Persons going to work on height are medically fit. If work is above 3 meter, vertigo test clearance to be done. If required, other work permits to be obtained simultaneously. Verification of compliance by area owner and safety officer prior and during working. So all these things should be checked before starting the actual work at height. So why these work at height, the accidents, the safety preventions, systems are important. So you can understand from this point, in 1 second, your body will fall 10 meter. So in a second itself, the speed of our body is meter per second. Good body reaction time is 0.2 seconds. Travel distance in 0.2 seconds is 2 meter. By the time you react, your body will be 2 meter below where you were standing. And that is why more than 2 meter you should take the preventions for working at height. So in the 0.2 seconds, your body can react for that falling. So that fall protection system should be there. One of the fall protection system or the PP is fall arrest. Limits free fall to within 2 vertical meters of the initiation point, which reduces force by decreasing fall distance. So this is the fall arrestor, which can be used to avoid the falling from 2 meters. It consists of a lanyard, anchorage point, full body harness and attachment strap. So this lanyard is nothing but a device made of rope, wire or nylon strap used to connect the individual to an anchorage point and stop the individual in the event of the fall. So this lanyard is going to protect you from falling. It should be inspected prior to use, be protected against being cut or abraded, have a minimum breaking strength of 2 to 70 kg, be the appropriate length, be attached to an anchorage, not to itself. In another PP is safety belt. So full body harness with double lanyards, 1.8 meter long lanyards, scaffolding hook, front clip should be metallic, no cranks and no cut should be there. So you should have observed all these points, that is nothing but the checkpoints for using this full body harness, some safety equipments for fall arrestor, shock absorbing lanyards. Nowadays, these shock absorbing lanyards are popular in the industries. Material in the packed ears absorbing shock and reducing the risk of injury. So this is mainly useful because in the safety belts, the chances of injuries are more. That is why now the safety belts are replaced by the safety harnesses and with the shock absorber. Available with the web or rope lanyards. Expandable lanyards specially useful for the scaffold, steel erectors and construction workers where tripping might be a risk. So where the construction is going on, where the scaffolding use is there, then you can prefer the expandable lanyards. So this picture clearly indicate that these are the expandable lanyards and these are the normal. Twin tailed lanyards. So here two lines are there, Here only single line, single line, single line. Now there are two lines. So twin tail lanyards, that is the expandable twin tail lanyard, is an ideal choice for situations where 100% tie-off is required. Fall protection from the anchorage point, a secure point of attachment for lifelines, lanyards or deceleration devices. Anchorage point used for the attachment of personal fall arrest equipment must be located at or above the employee's waist, so that anchorage point is where the anchor is used. So it is located at waist, capable of supporting more than 2 to 70 kg per employee, designed and built to hold the maximum force of the fall arrest. This is the picture where you can understand what exactly the anchorage is, what are the lanyards. Then we have to use the helmets and hand gloves, safety shoes, etc. So this is the scaffold. So this is the full body harness which is used to protect from the fall. The attachment point of body harness is located in the center of the wearer's back near shoulder level. Body belts are not allowed on sites. Snap hooks shall be double locking type. So how to avoid this fall? What PPEs are required? What you need? So full body harness complete with rear dorsal ring, that is EN361 reference, 1.75 meter fixed length lanyard, that is EN362 reference, and shock absorbing devices, references EN355. So you can understand what exactly the anchorage is, how to hold this anchorage to the lifelines, how to use this anchorage with the safety harness, and how to wear this safety harness. 55 mm opening scaffold hook for one-handed operations. What is the fall protection? Care for fall arrest systems are: after a fall arrest, the equipment will no longer be used. Equipment will be disposed of or destroyed, because that is designed for a single fall protection only. So after that, that may be deteriorated. Clean equipment after use. Air dry equipment, do not hang in direct sunlight. Store equipment in a cool, dark, dry, well ventilated place. And these pictures clearly mentions you how to use this anchorages, how to use these lanyards, how to use this safety harness systems, then different PPEs like hard hats, helmets, hand gloves, shoes, and some instruments like crawling board, which is basically used for the fragile groups, and some barricadings. So these are the PPEs and equipments used for the working on height. Normally, the fragile roof, that is AC sheets or metallic roofs, are there in the industries. Some requirements, that is vendor evaluation, content safety clause, then safety manual systems. Safety manual is issued to every new contractor introduced in the department. This book contains introduction of safety rules, personal protective equipment, height work procedures, general guidelines regarding safety and precautions, etc. So that manual should be used by each and every worker who is going to work on the height. Then you can go for the civil dexterity. So this dexterity can be used for the training purpose, for the induction training, for the training of the contractor or subcontractor workers, and which is essential for work permit systems. Some models can be designed before going for the fragile roof operations. Then some periodical training can be designed, planned with the help of that dexterity as well as some expertise persons, then vertigo test should be done before going for that height work. Then permit systems, work permit system is already discussed. Then loto system is already discussed, and this anchorage provided over the RCC gutters. So all these things are the requirements of the working at height safety requirement. Then these are the safety net requirements, specialties required when the construction is going on. Then safety net and tarpaulin roof replacement. So if you want to replace the roofs, because nowadays we are using the mild steel roofs instead of these AC sheets or asbestos sheets, so we have to replace these traditional sheets by new sheets. So for that purpose, we should adopt the safety net systems before starting the actual work. Then some temporary lifeline can be utilized for working at height, and some anchorage points should be provided for that lifelines. Crawling ladders or crawling boards should be provided for the replacement of these sheets. Then skylight pipes. So PC dome collects and concentrates ambient daylight. PC brought from a multinational company, UV stabilized, etc., can be used in your industry. So for the natural light or the sunlight, you can use these sheets, you can replace the sheets, you can repair and maintenance this sheet. But for before going for this type of work, you have to go through the work permit systems. So these lights are very useful, and it also saves the energy. So where the poor quality is there, you have to use this natural light. Sometimes artificial lights are required if the natural light is not available, especially in the rainy season in India. Some waterproofing systems can be adopted. So this can be prevent the deterioration of the fragile roofs or AC sheets. So we can go for this silicon sealant with gun can be used for waterproofing systems. Some mobile elevator platforms can be used. Do not operate without pre-use inspection and unless you are trained. Check conditions of tires, tow boards and guardrails. Look for leaking hydraulic fluids. Looking out for overhead constructions such as power cables, unstable ground, other equipments, personnel nearby. Only use on firm level grounds. Make sure outriggers are properly extended and choked before raising the platform. Always wear a safety harness secure to the platform by lanyard. Safety means staying in the baskets and not climbing on the guardians. So these are the mobile elevated work platform. Normally, if you are looking at the work where we are replacing the skylights, we are replacing the street lights, etc., so that mobile elevated work platform can be used, including that baskets. Place barricades and warning signs around the plan work radius. Traveling with a boom is always in the direction of travel and at creep speed, and only if equipment is designed to allow this. So you have to check all these things, whatever the design speed is there, whatever the design capacity of workload is there, and what is the design height for that particular boom is there. Know what to do if machine fails with platform in raised position. So you should know the repair or maintenance tasks if the machine is failed. Now these are the pictures which can clearly mention what are the safe access, and that can be possibilities. So this is the overloading and collapse of the scaffold. So falling off the platform, unguarded edge. So this is nothing but the top of one of the truck, which can be acts as a scaffold. But this is not the good practice. So you should use scaffold instead of this truck or the container. So fall distance before using guardrails depends upon the height and what is below. Risk assessment always call for before working at height. Now things to think about that if working outside, what is the weather condition, duration of expected work, so that should be less than 30 minutes. What is the light, so natural light or artificial light is present or not, whether that light is sufficient to work at that height, the place point work, height, ease of access, stepping of points, equipment should be used to gain access, etc. should be checked. Movement of materials, equipment should be checked. Ground conditions, whether the ground is soft or not, whether it is having that specific slope, whether the slippery conditions are there or not, what are the ground conditions that may be, that should be even ground conditions. How close to edges, nearly fragile surfaces, factory, vents, chimneys, hazardous fumes, etc. Falling objects on the others below, training, experience and competence of that staff. So all these things should be think about before starting the actual work at height. So this working at height preferred control list, avoid working at height, main reason. An existing safe place of work, provision of work equipment, worker restraints, wire and harness, fall arrest devices and harness, safety nets or airbags. So all these things should be used for working at height. So these are the different pictures where the we can go for the fixed platform instead of the moving towers or the moving scaffold towers. So this is again a ladder, but it is a fixed ladder. So this is again a ladder, but this is the good ladders having railings, then barricades. That barricades are also fixed. So these are some semi-mobile steps of staging. So here semi means here some wheels are present, and here small wheels or locks are available. Here also the height is very less, but still railings are provided, and the gap between the ladder is also very less to avoid the falls. So this is the scaffolding. You can use this scaffolding for repairing, maintenance or regular check on the overhead lines, which is used for these electrical lines for trains or railways. So these are the some pictures which can clearly indicate the mobile steps or the scaffolding. Now which things should be avoided? So we are knowing, we are discussing all these things, that what is the legal references are there, why the 2 meter or 3 meter height is very dangerous, why this working load, safe working load or barricades should be used, some specific equipment or the proper selection of ladder, proper selection of scaffolding or the proper selection of personal protective equipment is very essential. But still some of, in some of the industries and some of the peoples are doing wrong things, and that is shown in these pictures called as gallery of horrors. So you can understand forklift trucks. Forklift trucks is used as a ladder. So this is again another example. We have to avoid these things. So you can understand this again, forklifts are used. So there is no safety harness, crawling boards, lifelines, and still work is going on. Now these locks and these ladders or scaffolding are not on the ground level. Some other materials are used to increase the height of that scaffold. This is another wrong practice. So these ladders should be replaced. Railing should be replaced. Uneven heights. Repair, maintenance or replacement is needed. Now you can understand from this picture why the working at height and work permit systems are needed in industries. What are the takeaways? Risk assessment of task before start. Prepare method statement for non-routine task. Training of persons involved. Ensure proper access is available. Ensure adequate edge protections, barriers, anchor points. Scaffold erected as per specifications. Ladder in sound conditions supported by other persons. Use of helmet with chin strap and safety harness or fall arrestor should be used. Consider use of safety nets as appropriate where required. Coordinating of area, adherence to the work permit systems and the checklist. So working at height, no job is so important that it can't be done safely. Under no circumstances are persons working on this site to put themselves in the dangers. So you should do the work, but in a safety manner, right? So be safe today. Thank you.